I'm Ranger Kooky, and today I have a box opening and two mail times. Alright, first, this is my new bug out bag, but I have some new stuff to add to it. Some better stuff than I have, I think, I hope, or add to it. I got two special gifts. One's from Tom Clitwood. He has a surprise in there, so I want to take a wild guess. He built me, I do believe he built me, a canteen container. If it's not the container, it might be a tarp. So I took a wild guess. I'm going to find out what it is in a few seconds. Then, the second mail is from Bush Southpaw Bushcrafters. I want to say thank you, and I know I heard you gave me a sweet gift besides the trade, and I'm going to treasure that gift forever. I'm going to use the hell out of it, whatever it is. I'm going to find out what it is. I do believe it's a fire kit made with one of your special bags. Hey, you guys, go check her out. She has these little fire kit bags, and I guess she sells them or trade them. Check her out. She might trade with you for some information from her. That's the Southpaw Bushcrafters. And Tom Clitwood, he also does all kinds of work. Ask him about his work. He made this baby, and he made this. Now, I have weighed this, and it weighs about 40 pounds. Don't feel like it, but it weighs 40 pounds. This is my bug out bag. I'm going to take it apart because I got some stuff to add to it. Then this is part of my bug out bag system, or my stuff I usually carry with me all the time. And this weighs 10 pounds with all the water and the blades I use on it. For Jason McDillon, Krillin, sorry for your name calling, but you asked about the weight of this pouch. This thing weighs 10 pounds with all the water and the little gear I carry. Plus the 41 pounds, I'm sorry, I'm number right. There was 41 pounds for this bag, but I might take out some stuff, it might weigh less. All right, let's put this on the side. All right, box opening. This is a very important tool. I'm like, why is that, Ranger Kooky? Well, you need this in your car all the time. What happens if you get a flat and an emergency situation? My video called Invasion, the BOB, using my BOB bag in an invasion, I had a flat tire. But now I can pop it up with no problems. I can charge my phone with this thing. And I want to take it out right now, show you, and do some other, I can charge my phone with it. I can pump the air and start my car with this thing. You can also hook lights to it, but make sure you have low watts lights. And all the stuff I got, and I only got a knife. Ew! It almost got me, mama. All right, check this baby out. This is the most important tool you should have in your car if you're in an emergency situation. This thing can give you lights, charge up your phone, start your car, pump up your tires on your vehicle. It comes with a couple wires, a charger, instructions with some, you pop up a tube or whatever at a park, or and pop up your tire on your bike. And if you want to get kinky, oh yeah, oh yeah, all right, this should have some juice already. See, and I can also plug a cigarette lighter in there. There's another little UPS plug in it, right here. USP plug, a cigarette lighter. I could plug this in my cigarette lighter and my car is started, and also has a light. so I can see what I'm doing at night. If I get if I broke down on the side of the road, got a light. This is to turn the juice on. Battery status is on 2, so I have to charge it for tonight. And this baby is all there, and it's supposed to have an air compressor. If I can find the air compressor. It better have air compressor. I bought it for the air compressor. Ah, there it is. How do you turn? Oh, there it is. The main reason I bought this is for the air compressor, but it has other. When you buy this, it should be a pre-charge, but not all the way charged. You still gotta charge it. I recommend. So I'm gonna put this in my house and charge it for tonight because my tire is flat. Now, like I said, if you in an emergency situation, this is the thing you need to get. One of these. Why? Because they got all kinds of things. I can charge my phone with it. I can get lights from it. I can start a car with it. Pump up my air with it. And I got a small light. So I recommend if you got a bug out bag, you need a BOC too, a bug out car. Make sure you have 2 gallons of water in your car also. I keep forgetting to put mine in. But those 2 gallons, one day you're gonna need that 2 gallons because you might break down in the middle of nowhere and there's no ditches on the side, no buildings. Guess what? Your car's overheated. You can't go nowhere because you got no water in your radiator. But that 2 gallons in your radiator will help you out. Plus this big thing. All right. It's a Stanley FlatMax, 350 amps. I can plug all kinds of lights in this thing. I could, like I said, all right, let's finish this is over with. This is good. Put this on the side. All right. And it comes with little attachments. Might put all together. So the little bag is always with it in case I need it. And all the accessories also with it. So if I need to pump up my tire or my car, I can. See, my car is low. I learned a lesson. So this is good to have in your car. So make sure if you in an emergency situation, please get one of these for yourself. You don't have to listen to me. It's a suggestion. All right. Get out of my way. Trash. World's filled with trash. All right. And then my first box opening. Which one? Which one should I open? The Bushcrafters? And guess my prize? Or Tom Clitswood. Let's find out. This box been used many, many times, I see. So I'm going to try to use it again. You're going to have labels all over this thing. All right, I'm going to go ahead and open Tom and leave the best surprise for last. It's like having a, what you call a dessert at the end. Yeah. All right, I took a wild guess with what he created for me. What else? I think he created a, how the hell? He got this thing almost childproof. A box within a box. Wow, that's weird. He downsized it. Whoa, he's a, thank you, Tom. I forgot about the pillow. I said, yeah, I love your pillow. Look what Tom made for me. Thank you, Tom. I forgot the pillow. All the guesses I took and I got the wrong one. I was talking about his pillow he made. He just rolled it up. Ow, get out the way. All right. Just fold it up like so. Then you take the. Ah, look at that. That's a bundle. Thank you, Tom. appreciate that. I'm going to use the hell out of this one. Throw that other piece of junk away. That goes in my other bag. You know my other bag only weighs 4 more pounds than this B.O.B. bag? I think I got too much. Then I asked Tom to make me some straps for my hammock. Because it was a simple thing. He just went whoop, 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 and was done. Damn you, Tom! But thank you, Tom. I'll try to figure out how to use it. What the hell? Okay, that goes there. That goes over here. Yep. All right. He made me two from both sides. Thank you, Tom. I'm going to use the hell out of these. Then when we was out there, when me and Tom was camping, disaster struck. Lucky for Tom, he had one material. See, when you got a tarp going over your hammock, and it got pieces sewn into the other and makes it bigger, you have a chance of it leaking. So Tom sent me some gook, whatever you call it, seam gook, seam sealer and outdoor repairs. Welcome to Seam Guy. And he brought and gave me 3 little brushes of more than 3. I guess once you use it, you have to throw the things away because you only got like 4. I want to say thank you, Tom, for beautiful gifts. I will use the hell out of these things because Tom helped me because I got rained on. Oh, I'm getting wet. And Tom laughed at me. Good for you. Damn you, Tom. One tarp. All right, the favorite, the best gift. I did a trade with the Softpaw Bushcrafters, but she said she has an extra gift for me. I want to find out what it is. I'm guessing it is a fire kit. A fire kit. So I'm taking a wild guess what it is. A nice fire kit, a pouch. Oh, man. Oh. Got a letter. Thank you. I'm gonna go ahead and read it out loud. I hope you like your new bags. I put some of my fire starters in there and some birch bark. I also gave you a piece of I've never seen that word before. Shabby for a something for my sharpener, my knives. Thank you to keep them good shape. Thanks for all the laughs and for your meat trade. Thank you, Dawn. Softpaw Bushcrafters. This little letter is going to be put away. Let's see what I got. Oh, yeah. You know what this is good for? Now watch, I cut. I guess you got to go. Oh, it cut it. I have to watch a video how to do this stuff. Was it going that way? Or watch, I'm doing it wrong. Hey, look, I want to tell y'all that. Something. I'm not very good at sharpening knives. My dyslexia kicks in. You can teach me a thousand ways how to use this thing and I will forget and use it backwards. You say go this way and my mind will go that way. So I'm sorry. Please forgive me. But hey, you can teach me. Send me a link below. I'll be happy to watch. I guess you go like so. I guess I'm using the wrong side. Well, thank you for the nice gift. What else we got? Oh, man. Now it looks like I'm back in the 1800s. Oh, cool. I got a dagger, man. I got a dagger, man. That is so freaking cool. Like I said, go visit them. They got some stuff on sale, or she makes these pouches and she sells them. Go give her some love. Let's see. Ah, this is what I've been looking for. This is what I've been looking for. This is what you use to light fire with. Damn. And I got some briquettes, whatever you call these things. I got some weird stuff. So let's take a look at all these stuff and see what bags I'm gonna keep in what bag. Because I got so many bags. And the same little thing, I got a dagger. It's a bush. Okay. Look at that. Look at that pouch. Damn, heavy duty too. Like I said, go over there, give her some love, give some Tom Clintwood some love. They do excellent work. My work is like crap. Damn. I'm gonna see if I can start some fire with this baby. I heard it's very tender and easy to light. So I have choices. I like the little one for my my bag I got. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I don't know what to do. It's so much. Yeah, y'all lucky you got birch bark in your area. I got pine and crap wood. Alright, I'm gonna put some of this in this bag. Because I might use this for my BOB bag. I don't know. Hard to decide what bag to put it in. I got so many bags, it's unbelievable. Okay, look at that. I like that. It fits perfect. Now I have to watch a couple of videos how people use their bag. Because I'm confused which way to do it. Some good work. All right. I want to say thank you, Southpaw. I appreciate that. I might use the same box to mail to somebody else. And before I go to my bug out bag, I want y'all to please go to the Flesh Eaten. The Flesh Eaten Barefoot Trail Bandit and subscribe. He has some good stuff on his videos. Remember, the Flesh Eaten Barefoot Trail Bandit. So give him some love. He don't have that many subscribers, but he knows his goods. So go over there and give him a look-see. And thank you, the Bushcraft. I'm sorry, The Flesh Eaten Barefoot Trail Bandit. But subscribe. Well, I'm getting subscribed. Subscribing, I guess. And let me know about my BOB bag. Thank you. Alright, let's go over there and give him some love. Alright. The BOB bag. The new improved bag, I guess. What's on it? What's new? Right now I have everything, even my knives, on this bag. So I just took all the weight that I usually go to carry on this bag and put it on there. I put my little, bush saw, whatever you call this damn thing, with Tom's little handy dandy bag. Let's move it over so you can see this. I have a little bitty flashlight. I have the SOS knife. I'll show you what that's all about real quick. The SOS knife. It's just a little survival knife. It's a neck knife also, but I'm gonna leave it on my bag. Comes with its own striker built in. And all that I do is put it on my bag like so, put this rope through, and lock the blade so I can just grab this blade off my bag when I need it and just put it on here and lock it on with the safe strap. Okay, I have two little clips. Now over here at the bottom, this is a new bag. The bag Josh have sent me, it was a good bag, but it is missing a lot of parts. They didn't have the bottom bag, they didn't have the side bag, they didn't have this. Is the most important thing on your bag. Your shoulder straps is the most important. And also I got the K-Bar 11 neck knife to go with this system. I make sure I take it next time because it's on here. I forgot this. That's what happens. I want you to do that scenario as much real you can. I got my two bracelets with the watch. Now, I was saying, the bag I got from Josh, if I'm not mistaken, did not have this or the shoulder straps. They had the old shoulder straps, but they didn't have the pads. And didn't have them right. If you have a good shoulder strap system, see this? If you have that right, that bag was a killer. I'm glad I did a test. I did not like the bag or the back system, so I have to upgrade that right now. I just came off a vacation, so money's a little tight right now. But hey, all right, flip it back over. Now, in the bottom, this is the things I have added. I added some clothes because I noticed almost every bug out bag, no one has clothes. They might have a shirt or so. Then in my bug out bag, I have the stretcher bed so I can make my bed. And once I get there, I establish a base. And this don't weigh much. This is just a piece of cloth. This is also a piece of cloth. And this is my bush chair. And I have another bush chair I want to work with when I get out there. So I got two types of bush chairs, or I can make this a table. Depends on me, what I'm going to do. Now, I added this. This is MREs, the heating pads. And the little water pouches. Some of y'all know what these are. You put your food in there, you throw a little bit of water. You have hot food with these things in no time. In 15 minutes or less, you'll have hot food. And they're small and easy to carry. So in an emergency situation, I should have where I can make hot food less than 15 minutes. This is the new item I have added besides my clothes. I have a... Believe it or not, this is an emergency or a cover. Because once you go out there, you arrange yourself to be in shelter, but you don't want to be right there where your hammock is. You want to be away. You're sitting by your fire, and you want to cover your fire real quick. This baby right here is going to help. Now, I instantly got 5 feet of instant rain cover. Now, you know what this is? This is for hunters when they go hunting. They put this on top of they tie this to a tree so they have a little shade from the sun. It's also good for shade from the sun also. That's another reason why I got that. Two good reasons. Shade from the sun and shade from rain. That's 5 feet. That's almost tall as me. Oh, I'm sorry. 4 feet. This thing don't weigh much. That's why I want it. That's why I got it. Multiple use. That's what you want in your pack. Multiple use. You don't have multiple use for clothes, but hey, you go out there and you out there surviving for weeks and weeks, and you only got one pair of clothes. They go rare. Tear, you got to wash your clothes. You got to be sanitary. If you get dirty or nasty, you got to clean yourself. That's why I chose my bug out area. I got a shirt and pants and some other clothes items is in here somewhere else. All right. I noticed when I went out to do my trowel with my system, I noticed that my trowel, my fleece was getting a little damp and wet. You don't want your clothes or your belongings to get wet at all course. And I put a small towel. Because what happens if you're out there, you're cleaning something, like fish, you have no towel. I got a towel now. I noticed a lot of stuff I've been missing. And I've been watching other people's videos. Hey, you're missing something. So I added these items because you need these items. You need a towel. And you need a bag to keep it dry. If you don't have something to keep your stuff dry, and it gets wet, you can get sick. You can die. If you was a real emergency situation, this is why I'm doing this. I want people to use, if you got a bug out bag, I want you to do it in a trowel. No one ever has a video of doing this in a trowel. Oh, this is my bag. And don't even use it. All right, that bag is empty. Now, on the side. Now, over here, I got my other knife. This is the knife I got from Josh. The Sears knife. Whatever you call that damn freaking knife. Big, heavy duty, full tang. 150 feet thick. Thick. And I have that. I do have. All right, here's my food items. You already saw my food items, but what the hell? It's the new bag. I'll go ahead and open it up again. I have MREs. Some grits. Rice. Some white meat chicken. Spam from Ham. Ramen, top ramen, and a couple more boxes of rice-a-roni, the frito treat. Kind of treat you don't want. So I'm going to put that back in. We know this is enough food to last me about a week. Now everybody's different. I want to see what you got. That's all I'm asking. Now, like I said, I'm gonna say the next video you see is going to be in the invasion part 2 using this bag and all its belongings. Now, remember, everybody's level is different from everybody else's. My level, I like to have goods. I can carry it. I do a lot of practice. I carry 10 pounds of water and gear almost every time I go out in the woods. Up front, I have 3 bags. Heavy duty. You saw my videos how to use the 10 bag challenge, using 10 bags to create things that you really need out when you're out there. If you haven't watched it, go take a look. Oh, I want to say thank you to my new subscribers. I hope you enjoy my channel. I have only one request. If you do leave, please let me know why you left my channel. So far, I have almost 36 people that left, and I'm always curious why. They never answer me back. Oh, shit. I got 2 of the same value. This is a wrong. I'm glad I opened the thing, because I got 2 of the same items I need to put up. This don't belong in there. Why? This belongs over here. All right. everybody knows they gotta go. They gotta go. I have, since this is a BOB bag, you got to have at least a emergency kit. Because you never know, you might got hit, hurt, or whatever. So I got a drama kit that I got from Josh. What kinds of goodies in there? I got a little bitty first aid kit. I added some extra little knickknacks. 550 cord. My net. Now, this net can be used for three things. One, as a hammock, because this is a hammock. Two, as a bush chair. Three, as a net. Multiple use item. That's what you want to pack in your bag. Always multiple use items. In this bag, I have my water filter system. I'm thinking of missing all kinds of shit for this thing. And that filters, purifies water. Yes. Why are you keeping it in the bag? Well, what happens if I'm walking? I can walk with it now. I got it on a little bag. I can walk with it now. I can go anywhere. I can leave this whole bag somewhere and just take this because I got water now. Water's your most important thing. You can live longer on water than food. All right. Y'all saw this, but I'm going to reopen it up for my new subscribers in case they didn't see the video. It has three big nice tubes of alcohol for the alcohol burner inside for my little pot. In this little bag, I have a pair of work gloves. I got some vitamins. Just in case you can't get the food you need, you got a couple of vitamins can help you. It's not a food, but it's a couple of vitamins can help you, give you energy or so on. Men's vitamins, one a day. I got a little leather strap to sharpen my knives. A spool of rope, another spool of rope, and the SAS survival guide. Okay, watch out for octopus. And a knife, backup knife. I have what, three knives on this baby? One, two, three. Yep, three knives. Her work gloves. You see, I only add a few new items, which is my clothes. And once I establish my camping area, I'll make my bush bed and my bush chair and maybe a table with this items. I can carry the weight. I don't mind wearing the weight. All right, this is just a piece of tarp, all nice and bundled. I took a fire kit out. Because somebody said I had too many. And they say I had too many shelters. But I have to tell you this. In my new video, you see why I have so many shelters. Alright. In this bag, I have... I got Skull in here! Grizzly! Believe it or not, I've never seen that. I got some fat wood. And I have... couple of these little quick easy light system. This is my fire kit. They said I had too many fire kits and too many shelters. So I took a fire kit out. Shelters I have before. I got a reason to have that many shelters. Alright, I got a little bag here. This little bag contains soap, shampoo, and deodorant. Yep, it's the females, because it burns my skin, the alcohol. Now, the reason why I'm putting this in here, because you need to be sanitary out there. Getting filthy and nasty and getting a cut is a bad thing. So if you're going into a real situation of surviving in the woods, you got to be sanitized or sanitary. Alright, this is emergency radio. I can charge my phone with this phone, with this. Because with these little plugs and these little batteries for all types of phones. comes in this little cute little plastic bag within a bag. With a bag on top of it, in case you need a bag. And it comes in its little pouch. I think this is the last bag. And I got power 550 cord. Toothbrush and toothpaste. All right, you out in the woods and you get something in your teeth, it's gonna hurt you. You want to go find somebody to help you get that tooth fixed. So you're going back into population, you might get shot, might get killed, you might be kidnapped and used as experiment for them damn alien invasions. And another piece of rope. And this is for my containers to cook food. Believe it or not, that's what's missing on this bag. And this is my shelter, one of my shelters. I put an extra lighter now. My shelter comes with four stakes, tarp. The two tarps is a shelter system. I think that's what's in here, that's all. And a couple of garbage bags. And another 550 rope. All yellow, bright, so you can be seen by the aliens. Dare you move? All right, that's the last of that bag, and one more pouch. Remember, everybody's skill level is different. I think this is the I have a multi-tool with bunch of freaking things all over it. You know, mostly multi-tools have. This is a stainless selfie, whatever you call it. And the last two pouches, this is the light. I have a hand light and a headlight with extra batteries for both. See, I'm glad I opened my bag and found out these things are dead. See, I'm glad I opened it to find out, because I could be in the middle of the woods and now I have nothing. Good test. Now, I'm going to leave the batteries loose. That way it won't be charged. And I should have juice on this light. Yep. And that's my light bag. Then the last little dingity thing, it's another little, I think I got too many medical kits. Let's find out. I forgot. I want to show you real quick. This should have a magnifying glass. Nope, this is a fire kit. I got the wrong bag in here. Damn you, boy. So I'm going to take this one out because this is the wrong kit. I don't need another fire kit. I can put this with another, I can make another bag with this. So that's going out. I don't need that many fire kits. All right, like the guy said, you got too many fire kits, you need to take some out. So I'm taking the advice from the flesh eating trail, barefoot trail bandit. Thank you for your advice. There's other people who gave me other advice, but you're the only one really talked about my BOB bag. I appreciate that. Like I said, with my dyslexia and my concentration of getting organized, it's beyond. So now I'm gonna just pack up everything up. I have two lighters. This is my good fire kit. Radio. Wait a minute, fire kit, no, shelter kit, drama kit, some 550 cord, hammock with three multiple purposes, my water kit for getting water, I should put that on top, my cook kit. Toothbrush and a comb. And a comb, like I got hair. And a brush. Another 550 card. High jeans. MRE fire, not fire, but MREs to cook food with. These will come in handy if I need them. If I don't, hey, I got them. Remember, it's part of surviving. If you had to bug out of here, you gotta bug out. Bring some stuff. Don't be shy. Oh, I'm only gonna take 2 pounds. No. The 2 pounds of crap is not gonna help you with much. I like to see somebody take 2 pounds and live out there for a week, surviving on 2 pounds of equipment. What, would there be a saw, axe, knife, machete, a machete, ends this little video. I want to say thank you to Tom and Softpaw Bushcrafters for your amazing gifts. And Tom made these also. The bush chair, the bush chair 2, and my sleep cot. I'll say thank you, and oh yeah, and the 2 little things. Right now I wanted to put this, and this in a bag, and this in a bag. Alright, I'm Ranger Kooky. I just want to say thank you, Tom Clitwood. Thank you to Softpaw Bushcrafters, and thank you to the Flesh Eaten Barefoot Trail Bandit. Go over there and give him some love for helping me discover my B.O.B. bag. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and say goodbye to you. I hope you enjoy my videos. I can't wait for Invasion Part 2, cause it's gonna be like fun maybe. So, I'm Ranger Kooky, and I hope you see you in the next video!